How do I find this limit? I'm sure I have to use L'Hopital's rule, but I don't know how to apply it here. I'm also pretty sure my third step is incorrect. And let me take a look at your third step. Alright, so let's have a look. So here's the limit, and a and b are positive. And first you put this to be y, okay? And then I think because you notice that we have natural log, so you want it to exponentiate both sides. So e to this power and e to that power, right? And you got that. But here's one small thing. You're supposed to write down the limit as x approaching infinity, so don't drop that. But this is right here, it's not a major issue. The next step is the major issue. So right here you had e to the ln ln, and it just cancel the e and ln's. This right here is actually not correct. No, right? Don't do that. Here is the deal. So let me just make a note on the side. When we have e to the natural log, if it's just one natural log of x, and assuming x is positive, we're not talking about complex numbers here, assuming x is positive, then in this case, yes, you can cancel the e and the ln and just get the x back. This is okay. But if you have e to the ln of x over ln of y, in fact, there's no nice way to simplify this and that. You can use the change of base formula and you write ln of x over ln of y as log base y of x, but that doesn't do us too much good because the base this and that will not be the same. If you have ln ln here and you say this is equal to x over y because you cancel the e and ln's, no, this is not correct. So that is incorrect. So the rest, we don't have to look at it. And now the question is, how do we take off this limit though? Well, don't worry, let me show you. Just like you said, we will be used L'Hopital's rule. And the reason why is because if we put infinity into this x, b is positive, so positive times infinity is infinity, plus 1 is still infinity, ln infinity is infinity, so we have infinity on the top. And then, if you put infinity on the bottom, we also get infinity, similar reason. So we have an infinity over infinity case. This is the indicator that we get to use L'Hopital's rule. So this will be the limit as x approaching infinity. To use L'Hopital's rule, we look at the top and take the derivative of it. And let's just focus on that first. Derivative of ln, we just get 1 over the inside, so 1 over bx plus 1. And don't forget the chain rule. Look at the inside, multiply by the derivative of bx plus 1. The derivative of bx is just b. The derivative of plus 1 is just 0, so that's it. And we look at the bottom, take the derivative of it as well. Similar thing, right? The derivative of ln of whatever is just 1 over that, so ax squared plus 3. And then use the chain rule. The derivative of ax squared, use the power rule, put a 2 to the front, minus 1, so we get 2ax, and the derivative of plus 3 is just 0. So this is what we have. And then we just have to simplify it and hope for the best. So this right here is going to be the limit as x approaching infinity. And now on the top we have b over bx plus 1. And then for the bottom here, we can put this on the top, but remember we're dividing this. So we multiply by the reciprocal. This goes to the top, so we will have times that, which is ax squared plus 3. This on the bottom, so divided by 2ax, just like that. All right, now just kind of multiply this and use parentheses if necessary, like this. Multiply this out, we get the limit as x approaching infinity, and distribute, we get b times that, abx squared, and then plus 3b, over distribute 2x, so 2ab, x and x, we get x squared, and then this times that, plus 2ax. Yeah, now we have a rational case. When x approaches infinity, you have two ways to do it. One, you can still use L'Hopital's rule, or two, you can use the shortcut. The shortcut is, just pay attention to the highest power on the top and also the highest power on the bottom, and you compare them. If your teacher lets you to do it, then you do it. If not, I'll show you guys another way too. So in fact, this right here, we just have to care about this and then care about that because they both have x squared, yeah? So this doesn't matter. And again, x is big. It's because x is approaching infinity, so you get to do this. Now you see, this right here pretty much just gives you the limit as x approaching infinity, abx squared over 2abx squared. And the beauty of this and that, they all cancel. It's just 1 over 2, no more x. So finally, the answer is just 1 over 2. Just like that. So if you are in my class, in fact, I let my students do this. So yeah, that's it. But if your instructor does not let you do this, then you do it the following way. All right. You can still use L'Hopital's, but just check this out. Another way to do this is, here we have the limit as x approaching infinity. I'm going to divide every term by the highest power of x that we see, which is x squared. So here we have abx squared plus 3b. Yeah, I'm going to divide this by x squared. I'm going to divide this by x squared. On the bottom, we have 2abx squared plus 2ax, yeah? I will divide this by x squared, I'll divide this by x squared, just like that. Why? You will see, this and that cancel, and this and that cancel, and we can reduce that. This becomes limit x approaching infinity. We have ab plus 3b over x squared. And then this right here is 2ab, and then this right here is plus, this and that reduce, yeah? So 2a, but over x. Now, x goes to infinity. Ab stays, but this term, 3b over infinity will go to 0. This right here stays, 2a over infinity. This right here will go to 0. So we just get ab over 2ab, and we can reduce that. Final answer, 1 over 2, just like that. Hopefully this right here is helpful, and check out my other videos for more limit tutorials. That's it.